Hello everyone, welcome to our video today, taken on the Spectra Ultra STEM platform. Today I would like to show you our OptiSTEM function in the Velox software that tunes electron beam condition automatically to minimize aberration and improve image quality. What I have in the microscope is a gadolinium-gallium garnet sample prepared by a small dual beam. First, I would like to tilt the sample onto the 111 zone axis, and this can be done easily with our click-to-tilt function in Velox. Here we have just started our SmartCam, which sees the fluorescent screen. We can adjust it to be brighter and go to the natural mode to see the Kikuchi lines better. We can then center the diffraction pattern using diffraction alignment. Now I'm just matching the diffraction pattern to the crosshair in the center of the window. In Velox version 3.14 or above, we actually don't need to do this anymore because we will have some simple markers in the Velox software to guide through the process. Now I simply double-click on the zone axis center and Velox will tilt the sample for me. We can zoom in to the sample and verify that our region of interest has been nicely aligned to the zone axis. Now with my zone axis aligned, I can quickly focus my sample with Z. Then I can zoom into my region of interest to a magnification of around 10 million times, and we can start to see atomic columns. As I wobble through focus, I can see clear signs of stigmatism. Now instead of me trying to manually tune the stigmators, I can also right-click on the image and find the two buttons for the OptiSTEM function, focus and correct astigmatism. Now I can click the button for correcting astigmatism, and Velox software will execute this function. In a few seconds, it returns me a cleanly tuned image resolving the atomic columns nicely. We can now take a series of images and use the DCFI function to sum those images. If you're not yet familiar with our DCFI tool, you can also refer to our previous videos for more details. DCFI here stands for Drift Corrected Frame Integration. It minimizes the effect of any sample drift, and you can tell immediately that it's very effective in improving our image signal-to-noise ratio. We're now taking 10 frames, and each frame is a 1K by 1K image with 4 microseconds of dwell time. At the end, we have a very nice image of the sample. But this is not everything that OptiSTEM can do. For more advanced users, OptiSTEM also lives in our automated function platform Sherpa, and here it's even more powerful because it can also correct for second-order aberrations, namely B2 Coma and A2 the threefold astigmatism. Now we have just opened Sherpa software. In the OptiSTEM control, you see a button for C1, A1, and it's equivalent to what we just did earlier in Velox. It also has a B2, A2 button. Let's click the B2A2 button. This process usually takes a few minutes as the software finds the optimum solution for B2 and A2 respectively. It is going to start the algorithm by tuning C1 and A1 one more time. When it comes to the stage of tuning A2 and B2, a very nice feature here is that it returns a plot showing you the progress and what the image quality is like at each step. At the end, it tells us the resulting image quality is slightly improved in this case. Now we can take another DCFI series of images and sum the 10 frames. And now we have a high-quality atomic resolution stem image by exercising the automated OptiSTEM function.